And I was nominated by Sylvia Bruni and Dr. Gaby Mendoza Garcia. So thanks to all of you. And the purpose of the Poet Laureate, well, I'll tell you in a minute, but let me tell you a little bit about myself. That's me, that petite blonde who weighed only 100 pounds, I think, right there. That was me back in 1977. And to Clarissa, to annotate, what does that mean, Ms. Roxanne? Clarissa is requesting to annotate the shared content. What do we do?
Who's Clarissa? What?
Gonzalez. But it's, you cannot control the shared content until you stopped annotating. Clarissa, because our technology is very bad and we don't know, I am going to decline. I am sorry, Clarissa. I wish I could, but I don't know what's going to happen. Okay, can you please forgive me? And when I learn, I'll let you in. Okay, please. Ms. Roxanne and I have been for 3 days trying to figure out videos and music and, okay, young ones, maybe you can help us later. But anyway, this was me, and this is 1977. And the reason I started the poetry contest, both written and oral, is because there was nothing for the Spanish students to participate in, nothing. I mean, there was UIL, there was theater in English, but my Spanish students couldn't go anywhere. So I made it, you know, I started a contest in 74, and by 77, we had the whole city participating, and the guy in the middle was the citywide champion, Declamacion. It was all in Spanish. I'm a Spanish teacher for 49 years. Okay, and now, this is our this are my poetry for the whole year, and poetry is for everyone. Poetry is everywhere. Ya dijo el poeta Becker, no digáis que ha agotado su tesoro, enmudeció la lira. Podrá no haber poetas, pero siempre habrá poesía. So poetry is everywhere, and the main purpose for us is for everyone here to enjoy it and to know that it's for everyone. And so the purpose of the Poet Laureate is to share it with the community. And they told me they want me to highlight the diversity of the city, the uniqueness, and the beauty of Laredo. And if I should ask, what is the uniqueness of Laredo? I think most of you would agree with me that the ability to speak both in English and Spanish, write English and Spanish, right? You know, enjoy El Quijote and enjoy Shakespeare. That is a great asset, and it's a richness that we should be very proud. So that's the beauty of Laredo, in my opinion. That's the diversity from the rest of the nation. Because although the border goes, 2,000 miles long, not a lot of cities cherish our Spanish culture. I mean, especially in these times, there's a lot of discrimination against us, and they don't want us to speak Spanish. I'm sure you've seen the videos, you know, speak English, or we're in the United States. And no, here in Laredo, we relish our language and our culture. And now we go, because we are part of the library, I have to tell you that we would like to invite you to participate in the 18th Annual Poetry Festival. And I'm so happy that you can be a participant either in English or Spanish. And, you know, these are the rules. No, of course, original in any format, no more than 2 pages. And submit 2 copies. The deadline was today, but I asked Ms. Roxanne Garza, who's in charge, I said, no, please give us 10 more days. So just for the adults, the students already turned them in, but the adults, that's most of us, except for Ms. Sylvia Vargas students, the adults, the due date will be March 12th. So please, and the theme, of course, this too shall pass. And of course, it's about the pandemic, you know, but you're so creative, you can write about anything. So what are we going to write read today? Well, since it's International Women's Day, the purpose and the name of it is empowering women to succeed and be phenomenal in their own right. And I want to know if Ms. Trisha Cortez is here. Is she here? Is she one of the participants already?
Yes, Ms. Llanos, she just needs to unmute.
Okay, she needs to unmute. Ms. Cortez, we're so happy. We are so happy to have all of you in here. You know, the students, the teachers, my friends. And we need to empower women. We all have, we all have mothers to start with, daughters, sisters, of course, significant others. We need to make them feel that they can reach the stars. Okay, that because unfortunately it has not been like that for women. I mean, there is a lot of discrimination, and even in this 21st century, we see the murders, the violence, gender violence, and domestic violence, which is so unfortunate. And most of the victims, of course, are women. They always say, "Hi, but there's also men." Yeah, but you know, 90% are women, unfortunately. So I chose I hope these poems will inspire you. The first one by Maya Angelou, and that's gonna be our prompt for writing. Phenomenal woman. Maya Angelou didn't have a good childhood or a good upbringing, and yet she came out a phenomenal woman. And when she wrote this poem, it's for all of you. And in it, I'm not going to say anything. I want you to relish. And I've asked my good friend, Trisha, who's a terrific actress, to read it for us and just, you know, enjoy it. Trisha.
Rosa Maria, which one is it? Hay dos. Is it
still on? Phenomenal woman. Phenomenal. First, phenomenal woman.
Okay.
Have it? Yeah. Because that's our prompt. And because you're phenomenal and everyone here is a phenomenal woman, it doesn't matter your age. You know, I'm 74. It doesn't matter if you're 15, 25, if you're white, black, you know, Hispanic, green, anything, you know, pretty, fat, ugly, everything. We are all phenomenal. And I want you to listen to this.
All right, and here we go. Pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model size. But when I start to tell them, they think I'm telling lies. I say, it's in the reach of my arms, the span of my hips, the stride of my step, the curl of my lips. I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me. I walk into a room just as cool as you please, and to a man, the fellows stand or fall down on their knees. Then they swarm around me, a hive of honeybees. I say, it's the fire in my eyes and the flash of my teeth, the swing in my waist and the joy in my feet. I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me. Men themselves have wondered what they see in me. They try so much, but they can't touch my inner mystery. When I try to show them, they say they still can't see. I say, it's in the arch of my back, the sun of my smiles, the ride of my breasts, the grace of my style. I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me. Now you understand just why my head's not bowed. I don't shout or jump about or have to talk real loud. When you see me passing, it ought to make you proud. I say, it's in the click of my heels, the bend of my hair, the palm of my hand, the need for my care. Cause I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful, Trisha. Beautiful. Thank you. And we are all phenomenal women. and Maya Angelou gave us the recipe. And I'm always promoting reading. She wrote her autobiography. She has several autobiographies. I would encourage you to read the one I love the most. I Know Why a Caged Bird Sings. And she, terrible upbringing, but that did not put her, that did not break her. It made her a phenomenal woman. She has over 50 honorary degrees from universities. Okay. And she was she was abandoned by the father, the mother at different stages, et cetera. To me, that's our hymn, women. And now, women, so many of us don't like the way we are. Think women, my girlfriends, there is something that we don't like about ourselves. I don't like my hair. It's too dark. It's too, I'm too white. I'm too black. I'm black and I want to be white, and they're white and they tan, and I have curly hair. I want straight, but I have straight and I want curly, whatever. Lucille Clifton talks about her hips and how she has big hips and she doesn't care. She loves her big hips. And that's, we should love that, that what we hate about ourselves, that God, it's a God-given, so we should love it too. And it's a little short poem, but I love it. So Trisha, read it for us, please.
All right. Homage to my hips. These hips are big hips. They need space to move around in. They don't fit into little pretty places. These hips are free hips. They don't like to be held back. These hips have never been enslaved. They go where they want to go. They do what they want to do. These hips are mighty hips. I have known them to put a spell on a man and spin him like a top.
Wow, I'm sorry, I was distracted. Something's ringing in my house. Thank you, Trisha. And I hope it serves a lesson to all of us. This Lucille Clifton, homage to, and I'm sorry I didn't show you the pretty phenomenal women, pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model size. Doesn't matter how we are, we're all phenomenal. And now we're going to switch to Spanish. And a la mujer, Amado Nervo, one of my favorite poems. I read last time about Amado Nervo. He's my favorite, that's why. And Roxanne, let me make a pause. I'm getting a note from Ms. Patricia Gonzalez that she cannot open the link. You want to send it to her again, Roxanne? Are you there?
She's in, Ms. Deano. I just saw her.
Okay.
Patricia Gonzalez is in, and Patricia Costa.
Oh, well, good. Good, Patricia Gonzalez. Good to see you. I can't see you, but I know that you're here. Okay.
Gracias, Rosa María. Gracias, Roxanne. Aquí sí. Las escucho. Sí, gusto sí. Saludarlas a todas. Buenas
sí.
Noches.
Sí. We are just going to read, and then if you have any comments or questions, put them in the chat and we'll ask them later. Okay? I'll refer to them later. Van a ver por qué Amado Nervo, cómo se expresa de la mujer. Sí. Y este, para los que les gusta la poesía, vean que no es la poesía normal en versos, sino es lo que llamamos prosa poética, porque también puede haber prosa poética. En fin, dice Amado Nervo, el proverbio persa dijo, no hieras a la mujer ni con el pétalo de una rosa. Yo te digo, no la hieras ni con el pensamiento, joven o vieja, fea o bella, frívola o austera, mala o buena, la mujer sabe siempre el secreto de Dios. Si el universo tiene un fin claro, evidente, innegable, que está al margen de las filosofías, ese fin es la vida. La vida, única doctora que explicará el misterio y la perpetuación de la vida, fue confiada por el ser de los seres a la mujer. La mujer es la sola colaboradora efectiva de Dios. Su carne no es como nuestra carne. En la más vil de las mujeres hay algo divino. Dios mismo ha encendido las estrellas de sus ojos irresistibles. El destino encarna en su voluntad. Y si el amor de Dios se parece a algo en este mundo, es sin duda semejante al amor de las madres. Qué preciosidad, porque somos colaboradoras con Dios al traer la vida. Así que podemos escribir como Phenomenal Woman, praising one of our body parts that we don't like, o diciendo alabando a la mujer y sobre todo a las madres, ¿no? Entonces ya ven por qué Amado Nervo es de mis favoritos de siempre, ¿sí? Y ahora uno que leímos de una centroamericana, de una nicaragüense, y Dios me hizo mujer. Ahí la vimos en su foto, nació el 48, todavía vive en los Estados Unidos, es de Nicaragua, pero vive en Estados Unidos. Anduvo de revolucionaria, pero se casó con un periodista y se vino acá. Y ese también podemos, es un himno a la mujer, ¿no? Y Dios me hizo mujer, de pelo largo, ojos, nariz y boca de mujer, con curvas y pliegues y suaves hondonadas, y me cavó por dentro, me hizo un taller de seres humanos. Tejió delicadamente mis nervios y balanceó con cuidado el número de mis hormonas. Compuso mi sangre y me inyectó en ella para que irrigara todo mi cuerpo. Nacieron así las ideas, los sueños, el instinto. Todo lo que lo creó suavemente, a martillazos de soplidos y taladrazos de amor. Las mil y una cosas que me hacen mujer todos los días, por las que me levanto orgullosa todas las mañanas y bendigo mi sexo. Benditas mujeres, es lo que está diciendo Gioconda Belli. Belli es italiano. En italiano se Belli, en español Belli, pero Gioconda, el nombre lo dice todo italiano. And now we have poems of protest and resistance. Why? Because there are so many inequalities, you know? And we're going to continue in Spanish. And Alfonsina Storni from Argentina, Tú me quieres blanca. Sor Juan Inés, that Miss Sylvia Vargas is going to do the honor of reading three stanzas. Tyler Ford, I'll tell you a little bit about Tyler Ford in a minute. And another Maya Angelou that will finish our readings with Trisha Cortez also. So let's read the protest, the big, big protest of Tú me quieres blanca. And blanca is a metaphor, una metáfora. Vamos a estudiar un poco qué es metáfora y símil. Blanca es metáfora de casta y va a usar muchas veces chaste, blanca como las vírgenes, ¿no? Como cuando te casas, que supuestamente el blanco significa castidad. Y ella dice, ¿tú me quieres blanca? Le está preguntando al hombre que él tiene toda clase de pecados, él es sinvergüenza, X, todo lo que ha hecho. Y entonces, ¿pero a mí me quieres blanca? Es la... the double standard, ¿no? La discriminación de que el hombre puede hacer lo que él quiera, pero la mujer tiene que ser pura. Y Alfonsina Storni era, nació en Suiza, pero se crió en Argentina, tuvo un hijo fuera del matrimonio en 1912. Imagínense si ahorita todavía, pues gracias a Dios ya no es el estigma, pero imagínense en 1912. Entonces ella sufrió mucho por eso, y eso es lo que empieza, esta es la protesta de la mujer, que podemos escribir como mujeres fenomenales, pero también protestando. ¿Por qué hay tanta desigualdad en el mundo, no? Tú me quieres alba, me quieres de espuma, me quieres de nácar, que sea azucena, sobre todas casta, de perfume tenue, corola cerrada, ni un rayo de luna filtrado me haya, ni una margarita se diga mi hermana. Tú me quieres nivia, tú me quieres blanca, tú me quieres alba. Tú, que hubiste todas las copas a mano de frutos y miel en los labios morados. Tú, que en el banquete cubierto de pámpanos dejaste las carnes festejando a Baco. Tú, que en los jardines negros del engaño, vestido de rojo, corriste al estrago. Tú, que el esqueleto conservas, no sé todavía por cuáles milagros. ¿Me pretendes blanca? Dios te lo perdone. ¿Me pretendes casta? Dios te lo perdone. ¿Me pretendes alba? Huye hacia los bosques, vete a la montaña, límpiate la boca, vive en las cabañas, toca con las manos la tierra mojada, alimenta el cuerpo con raíz amarga, bebe de las rocas, duerme sobre escarcha, renueva tejidos con salitre y agua, habla con los pájaros y lévate al alba. Y cuando las carnes te sean tornadas, y cuando hayas puesto en ellas el alma, que por las alcobas se quedó enredada, entonces, buen hombre, preténdeme blanca, preténdeme nívea, preténdeme casta. ¡Uf! Uno de los favoritos de la protesta, ¿no? Y no estamos analizando porque no hay tiempo, pero espero hayan entendido que él ha hecho todo lo malo. Cuando él se haya ido como a un retiro, ¿no? Y hecho, cuando él sea limpio y puro como ella, entonces pídeme que yo sea blanca. Y la protesta más grande, yo creo que tenemos en español, es de una hermana, un Sor Juana Inés de la Cruz. La protesta, esta es fabulosa, del siglo XVII, Sor Juana tuvo que entrar al convento porque ella quería estudiar, era una mujer inteligentísima, dotada. A los 3 años ya sabía leer, no nada más en español, sino en latín, a los 3 años. Les recomiendo mucho, así les recomendé de que leyeran I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings. Está en Netflix, les va a gustar. Hay una serie que se llama Juana Inés, nada más así a solas, Juana Inés. Y sobre su vida, increíble su vida. Está ahí en la serie un poquito, bueno, le pusieron de más, creo yo, pero les va a gustar. Silvia, ¿nos quieres hacer favor de leer esta protesta tan grande que le hace hacia los hombres?
Muchas gracias, Rosy. Sí, cómo no. Muchas gracias por invitarme y gracias a todas las personas que están aquí.
Y Silvia, maestra de español también de muchos años, de Alexander, ¿verdad? De United.
Está. De Alexander, y aquí está uno de mis compañeros, Mr. Eduardo Bustos, también está aquí. Felicidades. De literatura.
Felicidades.
Sí, gracias. Ok, y aquí está de las poetisas favoritas mías, Sor Juana Inés.
Y además dijimos que nomás 3 estrofas, porque es muy largo y es difícil, es del siglo XVII, está el español en nosotros, está un poquito, pero ya después habrá tiempo, cuando ojalá que sea cuando estemos en persona, ¿verdad, Silvia? Lo podemos hacer todo.
Gracias.
Gracias, Silvia.
Empecemos. Hombres necios que acusáis a la mujer sin razón, sin ver que sois la ocasión de lo mismo que culpáis. Si con ansia sin igual solicitáis su desdén, ¿por qué queréis que obren bien si las incitáis al mal? Combatís su resistencia y luego con gravedad decís que fue liviandad lo que hizo la diligencia.
Sí. Entonces, ¿para qué las hacen hacer mal, verdad? Si las quieren buenas. Y tiene uno. Muchas gracias, Silvia. Y ahora vamos a unos de protesta en inglés. Uno de protesta. Este me gustó mucho. I love this one. I belong to the Academy, American Academy of Poets. I receive a poem a day. And then they ask you, you can teach this poem this way or that way. And so I was looking for a poem about women. And I found this too much. Too much is, I don't know if you were told, I was told, too much. Don't study too much because boys don't like intelligent women or men don't like intelligent women. That was in my time. I know mothers don't say that anymore. But right now, my sister's here, and one of her favorite sayings is, calladitas nos vemos más bonitas. Women should not be talking too much because calladitas nos vemos, I mean, we don't go into, we don't have problems. So women should be, you know, seen and not heard and all that. Baloney. We are just as intelligent as men, excuse me. and like Sor Juana, much more intelligent than many men of her age. And so I found this poem, Too Much, and I looked up Tyler Ford, and Tyler Ford is a transgender woman. And it imagine if we have problems, imagine transgender women have problems. So in my purpose is diversity. So diversity is inclusion of LGBTQ persons. And my son's a doctor in Tucson. And he tells me in the LGBTQ community, there's suicide because, you know, gays are not accepted or people that, and let's face it, God made us all. God doesn't make mistakes. He made us all. And in the LGBT community, the ones that commit even more suicides than others are the transgender people. Because imagine being born in a body that you don't feel you belong. You were born a man, but you feel a woman, or vice versa. You're a woman and you feel you're a man. And may I add, one of my grandchildren in Tucson is a transgender. And so it's very close to my heart. I love my child very much. And so I'm here for, I didn't do it because it was, you know, transgender. It just happened that it was too much. And I was surprised that it was a transgender woman. So for all that are fighting or for that equality and all. So this is too much. Do you remember the first time you were called annoying? How your breath stopped short in your chest? The way the light drained from your eyes, though you knew your cheeks were ablaze. The way your throat tightened as you tried to form an argument that got lost on your tongue. Your eyes never left the floor that day. You were 13. You're 20 now, and I still see the light fade from your eyes when you talk about your interest for too long. Apologies littering every other sentence. Words trailing off a cliff you haven't jumped from in 7 years. I could listen to you forever, though. I know speaking for more than 3 interrupted minutes makes you anxious. All I want you to know is that you deserve to be heard for 3 minutes, for 10 minutes, for 2 hours, forever. There will be people who cannot handle your grace, your beauty, your wisdom, your heart, mostly because they can't handle their own. But you will never be and have never been too much. I thought it was a very painful poem that this child, transgender child, was writing. Thank you for the applause. I'm seeing the applauses. Thank you. So, and if you notice, this is also poetic prose, like Amado Nervo's A la Mujer. Not verses, but poetic prose, and very, very powerful poem. So this is our youngest poet. She is only, or she goes by they. If you know something about LGBTQ, and it's a gender, so no gender for this person, okay? And still I rise. Okay, it doesn't matter phenomenal woman, and Maya Angelou, I was telling you, brought up in abject poverty. She was raped by her mother's boyfriend when she was 8, and she went into, she did denounce the man, and I don't think they found him guilty. You know how, what a horrible system we have, that she's black, I don't know, but he wasn't found guilty. And then when he came out of jail, not guilty, her uncles killed him. And she thought that because of her words, she had killed a man, and she felt the trauma of her rape and the man dying that had, she did not speak for 5 years. 5 years she was silent. But you know what? She read books. She read, and that's what saved her and made her what she is. And who brought her out of her 5 years of despair? A teacher, Patricia, Silvia, a teacher. Okay, so we know how important our job is, a teacher. I recommend again, I Know Why a Caged Bird Sings, because you can read this. But still, with everything else, still I rise. So that's hope for women. Okay, Maitricia, your turn with this very powerful poem. Still, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter how you were brought up. We each have our own destiny, and we can still rise. Okay, Tricia.
You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? 'Cause I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room? Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hope springing high, still I'll rise. Did you want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes? Shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries? Oh, does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it awful hard, 'cause I laugh like I've got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I'll rise. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I've got diamonds at the meeting of my thighs? Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise. Up from a past that's rooted in pain, I rise. I'm a black ocean leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear in the tide. Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that's wondrously clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise, I rise, I rise.
I love Maya Angelou, and thank you, Tricia. That was a wonderful interpretation. That's why I invited you. She's so, thank you, thank you, my Tricia. So now we are going to go, I hope these poems have inspired you. And now I am going to go to ones that I have written about. This is one of the ways that I do poetry. I respond to poems. Last time I responded to the love poems. And this time I'm responding to the poem Phenomenal Woman. And I've chosen two in English and one in Spanish from my list. This here you see, I wrote for Justice Patricia Alvarez O'Connell, and here surrounded by her friends, I'm one of them. And we were all committee for investiture. It was Judy Gutierrez, who is all here are phenomenal women. Because Justice Patricia O'Connell, you'll hear her poem in a minute, how phenomenal she is. But she's Judy, Webb County Commissioner, Dr. Marta Villarreal, the principal from Vidalem Treviño, Sylvia Bruni, the Webb County Democratic Chair, of course, Patricia Alvarez, Sylvia Palumbo, Webb County Clerk for many years, and Cari Elizondo, Karina, just elected to the LCC College Board. So, and of course, me teaching all these years. And then I'll read you one about my tía. This is me with my daughter and my tía, who's there 96. Right now, she's 101. Imagine, this lady is 101. And I wrote a poem for her, because at 99, I think she's remarkable. And then this is my family. That's me and my brothers and my sisters. And I'll read one about my upbringing, okay? And why I consider myself phenomenal. I didn't call myself phenomenal, but it's a metaphor, okay? So I hope you enjoy and see how you can respond. And I hope from this, you can get inspired to write, okay? And so I was inspired by phenomenal women. They told me, it was a committee for the investiture, and they told me, Rosa Maria, have to write a poem so we can you can read to Patricia. And I said, okay, what can I say about this woman? So I remember phenomenal woman, and I said, I am going to pattern after my, of course, I don't, you know, no le llego a Maya ni a los talones. I mean, I'm not Maya Angelou, but I responded to her. And remarkable woman, that's what you are, Justice Patricia O. Alvarez, and you serve as an example to all. Born in Mexico, came to USA as a single mother with a young son in tow. Undeterred, she started school. 3 years later, she had her BBA, received her master's immediately after that. Her mother from the Midwest fell in love with a dashing Mexican man and married him right after a whirlwind romance. Patricia is Mexican by birth and grew up speaking Spanish in school and English at home. Moved to Monclova, Coahuila, and grew up Norteña, like many of us here. She married young, had a son by 19. At 25, she decided to look for a better life and pursue her education in her mother's land. It was not easy with a young son to provide, but she was bold and determined. Remarkable woman, Patricia, that's what you are. Her law degree she obtained from UT with her son by her side. Practiced law for 25 years before deciding to be a judge. And what a judge she has been. Wise, ethical, compassionate are but a few of the adjectives your fellow colleagues use when speaking of you. Remarkable woman, Patricia, that's what you are. You've been selected to a second term, and how could you not be when you've been selected the best judge of the state where you serve? President of the Hispanic Bar of Texas, and these are but a few of the many accolades that appear in your resume. Remarkable woman, Patricia, that's what you are. Humble, sincere, proud of your heritage. You don't forget who you are, nor where you came from. Kindness, gratitude, and dignity abound in your everyday life. Remarkable woman, Patricia, that's what you are. We are so proud to call you our friend. We are so blessed to have you serving in the 4th District Court of Appeals again. Your presence here clearly attests that Mexico sends indeed its very, very best. Okay, that was my take on Phenomenal Woman. And thank you for the applause. Let me see. And this is for my aunt who just turned 99. And her name is Maria de la Luz Salinas. Well, she's Ceballos and Salinas by marriage. And she's my father's only sister. My father died when he was 52, and my tía is already 101, thank God. But when she turned 99, I was inspired and I wrote this. And in my way of being, she's a phenomenal woman. And this is what I wrote for her. It says, I come from good stock. Just look at my aunt who turned 99, fit as a fiddle, cooks her own meals, still remembers stories from old and relates them to us. We call to ask her for information and she obliges. Her memory is grand like that. But it is her amiable character, her optimism view, and her optimistic view and stride that has kept her so well. Every day. Please mute your microphones. I'm sorry, I didn't ask you. Please mute your microphones. She's always sees the best in everyone. She's never one to tell you anything bad. She praises each one all the time and makes one feel her favorite of everyone around. She has the gift of optimism galore, a Don Quixote of sorts, always looking to do well and treating others with the greatest respect. I've learned so much from this great example that God has set before my eyes and has led me experience in my personal life. She's a living example of love, unconditional. She's had a rough life, but you'd never guess from her disposition. I'll take that example and put it to work. Always see the best in people, make the best of every situation, treat people with dignity and respect, love family and friends unconditionally. This is what I've learned from this woman, this incredible woman, my aunt, who just turned 99. Okay, and that to me was a phenomenal woman because of the way she is and has not had a good life. She's had a lot of heartbreak, but still she's there. Like Maya Angelou, still I rise and still doesn't matter. You know, todas las cachetadas que me ha dado la vida, y ahí estoy. I still rise, still I rise. And this is in español. Esta está en español. Okay, y soy reina porque mi padre me trató como princesa, y reina es metáfora, it's a metaphor. Metáfora quiere decir comparas a algo con algo más, la reina como una metáfora de una mujer que es no rica, porque así empieza, no éramos ricos, pero que exitosa, que he podido salir adelante a pesar de muchos también cosas que me han pasado, infortunios, ¿verdad? Pero soy reina porque mi padre me trató como princesa. Me trató como, es una símil, es metáfora, símil, son lo que usamos mucho en la poesía, lenguaje figurado, como usó Alfonsín Storni, tú me quieres blanca, que me quieres, ¿verdad? Es una metáfora. Esta también es metáforas y símiles. Bueno, pues esta es la... Para, ustedes vieron la foto de mis hermanos, porque digo que mi padre nos erigió un castillo a todos, y por eso yo me siento así. Entonces, con todo cariño, aquí está mi hermana que me acompaña, ella estará de acuerdo con todo lo que digo de nuestra familia. Y empieza con, no éramos ricos, pero yo así me sentía, la más afortunada, porque mi padre siempre estaba ahí para protegerme y para ver que nada nos faltara. Me educó con mucho esmero, me animó en la lectura. De él recibí mis primeros libros. Me mostró las grandes obras de arte. Cuando viajábamos, lo primero era visitar catedrales y museos para que conociéramos nuestro legado histórico y artístico. A misa acudía a diario, comulgaba con frecuencia, traía rosario en el bolsillo. Su fe nos la inculcó con su vida diaria. De él aprendí a rezar y obedecer los mandamientos. Era humano. This always makes me cry. Pero en mis ojos era un santo. Y yo en su honor he tratado de seguir su gran ejemplo. No, no éramos ricos, pero yo así me sentía, como una princesa de cuentos de hada, por tener un padre que me trataba con amor, respeto, dignidad y gran ternura. Mi padre nos erigió un castillo donde nada nos podía hacer daño, donde nos sentíamos seguros, protegidos y lo más afortunados de todo el mundo. Nos enseñó con su gran ejemplo a ser amorosos, respetuosos, dignos, responsables y además tiernos. Oye, también es un homenaje a mi padre, pero es que yo soy, yo no me llamo fenomenal, pero sí exitosa y le doy gracias a mi familia, en fin, a mi familia. Yo fui afortunada que tuve esta familia, Maya Angelou, ¿no? Y de todas maneras podemos salir adelante, ¿no? Dejen componerme un poquito porque estoy, ay. Okay, I have, now we switch to English. It's getting the time that we have, I hope you are being inspired by these poems to write your own about a phenomenal woman. All these in certain ways are phenomenal women. Tips on how to write, these are my tips. I'm sure all the poets have other tips. My first one is to read lots of poetry. Read, if you want to write something, you have to read what other authors have written. And of course I have to promote the library. The library here in Laredo has a lot of books that you can check out. Right now they're closed, but you can use the curbside, like HEB curbside, you can use the poetry, the library curbside. And second one, respond to poems like I do by writing your original version, like I did for Remarkable Woman. If that, you know, not copying, you were not copying, but you are responding. To me, that was easy. Keep a poetry journal. I keep my journals and where is one? Oh, I don't know where I get one, but always keep a journal. And in there, put your images, your sensations, your happenings, etc. You never know when a poem might come. So I have one by my bedside, you know, because sometimes at night I get ideas. Use images with the five senses: sight, smell, touch, taste, hearing. Use metaphors and similes. Look up in the internet if you want more examples. Write free verse because it's the easiest, and practice other forms if you like. Most important, read your verses out loud. Poetry is like a song. It needs to be heard. You need to hear your poems. And number eight, I think poetry writing is a craft and you need to practice. And my tip to you, be adventurous, be daring, be you. Find your own voice. That's my take. And now let's write about, oh my goodness, we took longer than I thought. I'm sorry. But now I am going to encourage you to write. It's entirely up to you, of course. And of course our prompt is phenomenal women. And you decide what you're going to write about or who you're going to write. Think of all the reasons why. And this is what I would tell my students with calaveras: write without interruption for 5 to 8 minutes, and then review what your best thoughts, verses, words convey. At the end of 10 minutes, stop, fix your poem and get it ready to share if you like. And Cynthia Gallardo already said she's going to share her poem about phenomenal women, because last time she didn't do it. And your volunteers will have an opportunity to do so. And tell Roxanne Garza by private message that you want to read. And if you don't want to read, keep revising your poems, submit them to our poetry contest. Of course, the theme is different, but submit your poems for the poetry contest. So now you will have 10 minutes and I will start right now. Are there any questions or comments? Miss Roxanne, I mean, questions that I need to answer before. I don't know. No. Okay. No questions. Okay. Okay. Then we'll start the 10 minutes. And in 10, you want to play? Oh, no, we said no songs, right? Because the music was not that good. Okay, 10 minutes. And I hope we have a lot of people that volunteer with their poems. Good luck. We're going to unmute. You can unmute all of us. Where do I unmute?
Well, everybody can stay mute and turn off the cameras to write, and then they can turn it back on.
Okay, time is up. 10 minutes. Roxanne, do you have the volunteers?
Nobody's wrote me anything.
What?
Oh, I sent you one.
Cynthia.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
Well, okay. I don't see it here. Okay. So Cynthia should be the first one. She's the first poet to read.
Okay. Let's get some more poets to read. Come on.
Miss Silvia, come on, Miss Silvia.
Miss Silvia Vargas. No nos haga quedar mal.
Aquí estamos. Cuenten conmigo.
Okay. I know. Yo sé que siempre puedo contar contigo, amiga. Patricia.
Miss Patricia.
Hay dos Patricias que pueden. Patricia González, mi amiga del doctorado, y Patricia Costa, mi alumna de Martín, fantástica poeta.
Sí, también puedo leer un poema que acabo de escribir. Claro.
Okay. Fíjate que no vino Cindy Bernal. La estoy extrañando, Poetry Goddess.
I know she didn't. She sent me a thing and I sent her.
Yeah, well, maybe she couldn't open it like so many others, you know?
Yeah, Cordelia Flores also sent me an email that she couldn't. She had trouble with the link.
She couldn't. Ay, qué lástima.
Yo creo que ese fue el gran problema, que muchas personas hubieran podido asistir, pero al no recibir el enlace no pudieron.
Sí, no, how can you? But maybe we can do something about it, Roxanne.
Okay. Yes, I'm going to send it a different way this time. Sí, so it will sí, be...
sí. Because we had now how many participants? Do you have
we
the
have
number?
30.
We have 30. We could have had more, like 40, mm-hmm. I would say, you know? Yes. Pretty good.
Who else is going to read? Because I only have Cynthia, Silvia, and Patricia.
Patricia Gonzalez or Acosta?
Yes. Acosta, Patricia. I think she left already.
We oh, have Patricia Acosta left. Oh, she works. Maybe she was working. I don't know.
Yeah. Oh, and then Jamie.
Jamie is going to read too?
Yes.
Yes. And I thank you for your comments. I was reading them. And yes, Yaniel Ayala, yes, of course, transgender women are women, but this particular person goes by a gender. She, I don't want to say she, it's they. She uses they, the pronoun they are androgynous or a gender, neither woman nor man. No me preguntes más. That's all I know. Her biography, look. Them up, Tyler Ford.
Yes. Daniel
Mendoza is going to read.
Yes, he's going to read his.
All right.
So should we get started
Escribí
with
algo chiquito.
First? Manuel?
Escribí algo chiquito.
No importa, pues en 10 minutos. We understand in 10 minutes, we don't expect a long poem, but just, you know, at the beginning of, or a very good short poem or the beginning of something, and you can continue with a thought. But I hope that the poetry inspired you, and I thank you very much for your beautiful comments about this poems. That you know, I look for them so they can be inspiring to you and help you write. Okay, so ¿quién empieza, Roxanne?
Miss Cynthia
Gallardo. Yes, Cynthia.
Okay. Hello, everybody. So let me start with my poem. I applaud you. You, the woman who through pain and tears has succeeded despite the odds, who through disappointment has risen above the occasion and has not given up on love, joy, and living a fulfilling life, who despite heartaches still continues to believe in love. You who has dried your tears and has gotten back on her feet. You who, despite criticism and those loud voices that try to put you down, has held your head high and walked amongst giants. I see you. I hear you. I am you. Sisters, we can empathize in each other's journey. We are each other. Let's unite and hold hands in unity. Let's embrace our time here on earth and strive to live it with enthusiasm, positivity, growth, and self-love. I am you, and you are me.
Cynthia, that is so beautiful. And you know what, this just inspired me so much. I am going to ask you to share what you're doing this, you know, send it to Roxanne. I don't know, Roxanne, how can we, I would love to have this, you know, today's poems and have like a booklet. We're doing booklets of what, of the poems and of course with a recording and everything. That's beautiful.
What we can do is they can send me their poems through my email, and then I can see if Nikki can give me the cover and maybe ask her to do like a little background, which is like the same color.
And we are going to use the PowerPoint, you know, also you can.
So we can do that. We can use the flyer in the front as a cover, and then we can use like the one we do for Florida Poetry Festival, and we'll do it. All the points will be like published basically.
Right.
So we can do that if you want.
Yes, that would be nice because this is form, you know, I loved it, Cynthia. Thank you so much. And of course you would put something about yourself in when you send it. Miss Sylvia, yes. Miss Sylvia, ¿verdad? She's next.
Yes.
Okay, gracias. Este, le puse yo Yolanda. Yo vi en el infinito una silueta formidable de figuras y estrellas. Oh Dios, qué grandioso es este gran reflejo. La luz resplandeciente iluminaba la cara y aquí en el corazón sentí una fina diligencia. No sabía cuánta ternura desde el cielo se extendía. De esta imagen conmovida, con abnegación me veía y desde allá, allá desde el horizonte, lleno de rosas y finas estelas, vi a mi abuela desde lejos, viéndome con melancolía.
¡Qué hermoso, Silvia! Te iba a preguntar, creí que era tu mamá al principio, pero es tu abuela. ¿De parte de madre o padre?
De parte de madre.
¡Ay, precioso, precioso! ¿Ves? ¡Ay, qué barbaridad! Pero están fabulosos. ¿Quién sigue? Ay, lo mandas, ¿eh? Sí, mira, ya te están aplaudiendo ahí y yo te aplaudo también, Silvia.
Next will be Miss Patricia González.
Miss Patricia, looking forward.
Sí, gracias. Escuchándote de nuevo se me ocurrió escribir. Obviamente, una mujer que admiro muchísimo me dio un consejo una vez que me ayudó en mi vida personal.
Qué hermosa, ya sé de qué hablas.
Sí,
creo.
Estamos en Starbucks tomando un cafecito.
Sí, cómo no, Starbucks en Tamiyu.
Tamiyu. Sí. Rosa María, pilar de los dos Laredos.
Ay, qué hermosa.
Siento, has sembrado calaveras entrelazadas, floridas, escritas nuestras palabras con amores y sabores que cruzan el puente desde hace muchos años y dejas un legado de velas y papel picado, de agua y sal, de cempasúchil y también de copal. Calaveras en palabras, calaveras como ofrendas a nuestra gente finada, pero jamás olvidada. Gracias por esa labor, Rosa María.
Ay, Patricia, qué hermosa eres. Te quiero mucho, amiga.
Te admiro.
Sí, sí, gracias, gracias. Fue un placer. Me dio mucho gusto esa vez que me salió del alma ese consejo, tú sabes.
Sí, exacto.
Hablo con honestidad y con el de corazón en la mano. Mujer.
De mujer a mujer.
Sí, sí, exactamente.
Sí.
Sí. Es el propósito, ¿no? De la mujer, empoderarse uno mismo, porque es un mundo mejor. Es un mundo mejor cuando las mujeres nos ayudamos, las unas a los humanos, ¿verdad? Pero porque las mujeres que tanto femicidio, tanta desgracia que nos pasa a las mujeres, ¿no? Mucho más. ¿Quién sigue, Miss? Miss Roxanne, ¿quién sigue?
Jamie.
Jamie.
Hi. My poem's called Saturday Morning.
Uh-huh.
I remember waking up, clothes sticking to me from sweat, my mouth hot and dry, my hair in mats, remembering today is Mom's birthday. But as that thought surfaced, so did nausea. My knuckles white, gripping the sheets, not wanting to ruin it. The day meant to celebrate you, but you came in anyway. Amidst my tears and snot, you said, it's okay. Rubbing my back, my head in a bucket, saying it's fine. And it was.
Well, about your mom. And did you celebrate her birthday?
No, we didn't. We weren't able to because I was really, really sick that day.
It's beautiful.
But we did manage to the next day.
Yes. Be sure and you turn it in. You can also, you know, if you feel it, you know, whatever you need to do, if you need to revise it. I should have put in the tips. You know what I forgot when I was reading them? Number 9 should be revise, 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 because that's what writers do, you know. My poem, The Rain, all the 3 poems, I want to revise. I always want to change something, you know, but that's a thing with poetry. Revise, revise. So if you want to send it like that, or you want to revise it, and do tell us something about yourself, Jamie, and all the other authors, you know, a little bit, just so you will know a little bit about yourselves and who you are. And I know, Jamie, I saw you in the first one too, right? You were here. Thank you. Thank you for
being here. She actually turned in a poem from her school, so
good luck. Wow. Wow. From you go to Alexander with Ms. Vargas? What school do you go to?
Washington Middle School.
You're in middle school? My goodness, more power to you. Wow. Well, you're going to be one of our great poets. If you're in middle school and you're already writing this well, okay. Te felicito, hijita. Okay. And to your mom, too. ¿Quién sigue me? Roxana.
Daniel Mendoza.
Ay, Daniel, mi alumno. Ah, casi mi hijo, Daniel. Él sabe. Sí. Mis alumnos siempre los adopto.
Sí, sobre todo a mí. Gracias por toda la inspiración y por su ayuda de tantos años. A pesar de que no estamos en la escuela, usted como quiera me ayuda. En todo momento ha estado conmigo siempre. Yo escribí también algo chiquito, inspirado en todo lo que escuché esta tarde. Y a mí lo que más me indigna es la violencia hacia la mujer. Sí. Todas las cosas que han salido en las noticias últimamente y cada vez es más, déjame, voy a leer esto.
Sí.
¿Cómo puedes tú pegarle a una mujer? ¿Cómo puedes no admirar lo grande que es? Lo bella que es, lo admirable que es. ¿Cómo crees que llegaste tú a este mundo? No llegaste solo, te trajo una mujer. Eres el producto del amor de Dios y el de tu madre. Eres la oración que algún día ella hizo por ti. ¿Cómo puedes no valorarla? ¿Cómo puedes no amarla y respetarla? La mujer es fenomenal. Es grandiosa y amorosa. Respétala. Ámala y cuídala, porque algún día ella ya no estará.
Ah, qué bonito, Daniel, y en tan poquito tiempo, ¿eh? Pero vi ahí pedazos de Fenomenal, pedazos de Amado Nervo, pedazos de todos los poemas, y es por eso que los escojo. Sí, I choose the poems so they'll help you write something about phenomenal women in this, and of course, you know, Daniel, le inspiró, la inspiración es distinta, todo nos inspira de distintas maneras, pero Daniel, hermoso, gracias por compartir, hijo.
Por invitarme.
Ah, qué bárbaro, pues para la próxima también. Ahorita vamos a hablar de la próxima. ¿Quién sigue, Ms. Roxanne?
Well, I do have a student, but their microphone doesn't work, so they want to put it in the chat.
Sí, qué lástima.
Maybe somebody else can read it for him or something.
Sí. ¿Quién es el alumno? ¿Es de Miss Silvia Vargas?
Yes. ¿Cómo se llama?
Miss Silvia, ¿quiere leerlo? Está en el chat.
Se me hace que es de Yaniel y creo que Mr. Domínguez quería también leer el suyo, pero no estoy muy segura si es de Yaniel Ayala.
Sí, well, sí, he actually put it on the chat, Miss Silvia.
Yes, I can see it. They say red is the color of love, color of sex, fire, fancy, but the lips of a woman in red, they kill, they sting. That's not red. That's blood. Women of power is not to be questioned. Scarlet and crimson, fire and war. A woman in red cannot be ignored. Their kiss is that signal of death. They mark their territory. Their lips are knives. Blood, red, lipstick.
Wow, Daniel. Wow. Wow. I'd love to read it again. Okay. So send it, please. Send it. And yes, and may this be, you know, your inspiration, and may you, hopefully you can be with us throughout every time we meet, because I would like for you to be inspired like you were today. And then, you know, poems, they come from everywhere. That's why I had different poems about phenomenal women. And of course, phenomenal women protesting, and the protest got a lot too, you know, like Danielle certainly was a protest, and this one was love and, I don't know, sexiness. And Danielle, me encantó. Muchas gracias.
We have one more. We have Alexa.
Alexa.
Would you like to read yours?
Oh, yes. I'm not a poet, but I just got really inspired with the presentation and seeing everyone's poems that I wanted to write something.
Go ahead.
All right, Ale, aviéntate.
With soft hair and a warm smile, it's not fair the way you set my heart on fire. With bright eyes and a voice of sweet sugar, who wouldn't love to love her? Her delicate hands can move mountains. Her gentle features can stop a giant in its tracks. Who wouldn't love such power and grace? With sweat and dirt framing your beautiful face.
Okay.
That's hey, it.
That's you. You say you're not a poet. You are. We are all poets. Okay. We all have it in us. You love songs. I didn't talk about songs this time like I did last time, but a poem is also like a song. That's why you need to say it out loud. I loved it. I loved it. Thank you very much. And I hope if you're inspired, please come, please join us for our next. Is this the last one of the group that's going to share?
I think Mr. Domínguez Iruegas wants to participate, Rosie.
Ah, bueno, pero ¿dónde está? ¿No dijo?
Iruegas.
He's the Iruegas. One that said his, oh, there he goes, his mic. Yes.
Iruegas.
May I commence?
Yes, yes, please.
Now, this may be just a complete juxtapose from what Alexandra just wrote, but I would like to give some context first. Esto es basado, no necesariamente en un género, pero está basado en un personaje femenino de un libro por Mario Cruz, cual el título del libro no puedo decir por razones del distrito. Y por más contexto, esta persona sufrió mucho en el pasado y ahora está haciendo una clase de arte, podríamos decir, para aliviarse de su dolor del pasado.
Sí, 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 pero pues, ¿me puedes poner el nombre de la novela en el chat o no? ¿O tampoco?
Le puedo dar el nombre del autor, Mario Cruz. También se hace llamar Orián Sur.
Orián Sur, Mario Cruz, ok.
Es de Latinoamérica, creo que de la Ciudad de México.
Ok.
Muy bien, si me permite comenzar.
Sí, claro, gracias. Pero es sobre alguien de esa novela. ¿Es sobre el personaje de esa novela?
Un personaje femenino, sí.
Sí, gracias.
Poco a poco te pierdes en la creación de tu propia éxtasis, pero aún recuerdas a tu verdugo. Sola estás en tu propia oasis y aún te persigue la pesadilla en la que madrugó. Soñaste de esta libertad durante tu parálisis y aún Así el pensamiento te subyugó.
Wow. Bueno, pues, mis gracias. Lo felicito, te felicito, Iruegas. Perdón que no te puedo decir tu primer nombre, no lo puedo, perdón, Iruegas.
Mi nombre es Leister.
Muy inspirado, me encanta, muy inspirado, ¿eh? Gracias. Sí, y continúa con nosotros, porque tienes ahí un gran sentido de la inspiración, lees mucho, lees a Mario Cruz, está en español, me imagino, el libro es en español, te felicito que estés leyendo una novela en español. Acuérdate, un buen lector, a good reader is a good writer, okay? I know some people say maybe not, but we teachers, we go by that one, right, Miss Dominguez? También Miss Dominguez, Miss, yeah, Silvia Vargas.
Absolutely, I agree. I'm a
Patricia González, and Malena Charur, I don't know if Malena, oh, I saw Marcela Moran also. I didn't recognize, oh my goodness, I'm seeing some other names. Thank you so much, Malena and Marcela. I hadn't seen you before. Okay. And ¿quién más dices, Mr. Dominguez? ¿Se animó o no?
Mr. Dominguez es a Leister Iruegas.
Mr. Dominguez, ¿qué no?
Es que a Leister Iruegas yo lo llamo a Mr. Dominguez. Es la misma persona, Rosy.
Ah, perdón, ya leyó entonces Mr. Dominguez.
Así es.
Ah, bueno, perdón, creía que había alguien más.
Es que Mr. Dominguez quiere llamarse Mr. Dominguez. Y es a Leister Iruegas.
¿Y por qué no Iruegas? ¿Hay alguna razón? Perdón.
Iruegas es el apellido de mi madre.
Está bien.
Leister es el nombre que me dio mi madre.
Está bien, pues. Platicaremos después, si a tu conveniencia, ¿ok? Si es que quieres, ¿verdad? Pero encantada. Well, at this time, I guess it's time to say goodbye. It's almost 7:30. We were supposed to just take like 15 minutes, but I couldn't say no to these beautiful poems. And please send them, you know, revise them if you want to, or if not, just send them like that and tell us a little bit about yourselves. And hopefully you'll be here next time. Oh, here's the thank you. Next time we're going to be celebrating Shakespeare and Cervantes. And I'm inviting all the teachers that are here to, you know, to cooperate to with me and tell me which ones Shakespeare and Cervantes. Of course, Cervantes is not a great poet. I mean, he doesn't have he's a great writer, but not no well known as a poet, but it's not only Cervantes and Shakespeare, it's about the language, you know, the love of language, de la época de Cervantes, you know, Shakespeare has a lot of poems that you could say this is my favorite or not, and Cervantes does not have a lot of poems, but certainly we call it la lengua de Cervantes, no? En la lengua de Cervantes, de los clásicos, we will stay with the classics for next month. En los clásicos de Cervantes, en los clásicos de Shakespeare, ¿cuál te gusta? Acepto recomendaciones de poemas de todas las maestras que hay. Ya vi a Marcela y a Malena, perdón, y no sé si hay más maestras. Mary Sue Galindo se fue, algunos se fueron, pero sí, muchas gracias. Thank you so much for being here with us. Special thank you to all the students that were here with us tonight. Okay, and hope you can join us for next time. First Tuesday of the month, April, Shakespeare and Cervantes. Good night, everybody. Thank you. Un abrazo a todos. Muchas gracias, Miss Silvia, por traer a tus muchachos y participar. Mira, okay.
Muchas gracias. Buenas noches.
A ustedes. Buenas noches a todos. Bye bye.
Good night, and we'll see you.
Thanks. Thank you, Roxanne and Laredo Library for helping so much.
Yes, we'll see you.
Thank you for all participants. They were excellent. Thank you so much.
We had 30, so which is good.
Wow. Bueno, pues, nos vemos la próxima.
Yes, we'll see you.